an undiscovered oxygen production at the bottom of the deep sea. This is suggested by a new discovery in the Clarion-Clipperton Zone, which has caused quite a stir. Polymetallic nodules are responsible for the so-called dark oxygen. They could be of great importance for the organisms living down there. And that's not all. These nodules contain many critical minerals, such as lithium, nickel, and cobalt. In the Clarion-Clipperton Zone alone, there's 3 to 5 times as much cobalt and nickel as would be accessible on the entire land area of our Earth. No wonder there are so many plans to mine these resources. What the dark oxygen is all about, how it could have developed, and what a crazy case is currently taking place around the study, that's what we are talking about today. And with that, welcome to the German Science Guy. My name is Jacob, and in Germany we say los geht's. So according to the research team, oxygen is produced at the bottom of the deep sea by polymetallic nodules. These metal nodules are quite special. They are found worldwide on seafloors at depths of 3,000 to 6,000 meters or for our American friends about 10 to 20,000 feet. They're very common in the Clarion-Clipperton Zone, the Peru Basin, the Penrhyn Basin, and the Indian Ocean. How the metal nodules are formed is actually quite simple, through erosion, so the removal of soil, and from hydrothermal vents, which are basically hot springs located in the deep sea. They're formed where seawater penetrates through cracks and fissures in the earth crust, heats up close to the magma, and becomes enriched with minerals before it rises to the surface again. As a result, metal ions are repeatedly released into the sea. These metal ions are gradually deposited on a nucleus on the seafloor, such as a shark tooth or a shell fragment. As more and more metal ions accumulate on the nucleus over time, a metal nodule eventually forms. This process can take place in two ways. One type is so-called hydrogenetic, as the metal's ions sink from the open sea to the bottom. However, this takes quite a long time. Hydrogenetic nodules only grow up to 10 millimeters in a million years. Diagenetic nodules are a little bit faster. They manage to reach up to 100 millimeters per million years. The ions originate from the water in the seabed. The so-called pore water is located between the sand grains. This is seawater that penetrates the seabed and reacts with the sediment. So this is how they grow. Nodules 15 centimeters in size only develop if the environmental conditions remain constant and over extremely long periods of time, 15 million years for example. The nodules consist mainly of manganese and iron, but also nickel, cobalt and lithium. Now there's this new study. A research group has examined polymetallic nodules in the Clarion-Clipperton Zone, and their findings were that these small nodules produce oxygen and could be the basis for entire ecosystems. An international research team was involved in the study. These included the Scottish Association for Marine Science and GEOMA in Kiel in Germany. In 2013, they took measurements in the deep sea and detected possible oxygen production there for the first time. Back then, however, the team thought that the measurements were incorrect and didn't bother. In fact, every other study in the deep sea has only measured oxygen consumption. Oxygen production has never been detected. However, the team repeated the measurements a few years later. They used a method called the benthic chamber experiment. The principle is quite simple. You can imagine it a bit like a child trying to catch a small insect with a jar. The child puts on the lid of the jar and then waits a certain amount of time to see what has happened to it. This is exactly how it is done in research. Okay. It's a little bit more complicated, but it's the same thing. The metal nodules at the bottom of the sieve are enclosed in a glass dome. Various sensors can then measure the composition of the material inside the chamber over time. Over a period of 2 days, a 3 times higher oxygen concentration was measured in the chamber compared to the environment. This result was confirmed under laboratory conditions. Experts from GEOMA and Kiel also helped with this. This also made it possible to rule out the possibility that microbes were responsible for the dark oxygen. Of course, it is understandable that the research team was quite surprised by the results. After all, metal nodules somewhere on the seabed were not previously thought to be a relevant source of oxygen. It was assumed that oxygen is primarily produced on land, by plants or on the surface of the oceans. The new study naturally raises completely new questions. For example, how can metal produce oxygen at all? The oxygen in the polymetallic nodules is produced by the electrolysis of water. This produces H2 and O2. To split H2O, so water, you actually only need a voltage of around 1.5 volts. This is roughly the voltage of a small AA battery. In order to generate this voltage, the polymetallic nodules act as a kind of natural battery. The team was able to measure a voltage of around 0.95 volts on the surface of the nodules. They suspect this happens because different metals have been deposited irregularly in the nodules over millions of years and electric charge has developed between each layer. This voltage of 0.95 volts alone would not be enough to trigger the electrolysis of water. However, the team assumes that certain metals in the nodules act as a catalyst. The mixture of cobalt and nickel, among others, could reduce the activation energy to such an extent that electrolysis can still take place. This would make it possible for these nodules to produce dark oxygen in a place that many would not have thought possible. This dark oxygen could have a really big impact on the ecosystem down in the deep sea. So if the results of the study are correct, then this would be extremely exciting news. Scientists have long assumed that the first cyanobacteria also gave rise to the first aerobic life on Earth. But the new discovery could open up completely new questions about the origin of oxygen-dependent life. Even more, the metal nodules could be of great significance for the organisms living there and therefore also for us humans and our environment. The ecosystems in the deep sea are responsible, for example, for the constant storage of carbon. This is also important when we talk about deep sea mining because that means removing the manganese nodules further endangers life in the deep sea. Studies show that places where manganese nodules have been removed hardly ever recover. For example, a study shows that after 26 years, biodiversity is significantly lower in places where resources have been extracted from the deep sea. And now things are getting really crazy because one company was not at all happy about the results of the study. I briefly mentioned earlier that TMC would like to carry out deep sea mining down there. And their argument is that they need the resources for the energy transition. The interesting thing is TMC co-financed the new study on the production of dark oxygen, among other things. However, after the results were published, TMC took a stand and sharply criticized the results. In their press release, they spoke of false results due to oxygen contamination, among other things, and announced their own study to challenge this. And let me put this in a way. When I read that, I had a smile on my face while a small tear was running down my face. So actually, this sounds to me like I don't like the results of the study funded by me, then I will just do another study funded by me. A preprint of the new study, the second study, was published on September 18th. However, this preprint has not yet gone through review process. In the preprint, TMC argues that the research group did not provide a complete picture of the evidence. The oxygen could be explained by trapped air bubbles or leaking electricity in the device's use. As I said, it would be convenient for TMC if these were false results. And of course, it must first be said, it has not yet been proven beyond doubt that the metal nodules are actually responsible for oxygen production. However, the large number of measurements using various methods already indicates this. At the moment, further research is probably needed also to clarify how important is dark oxygen really. In fact, many researchers are still holding back their judgment. And I must emphasize once again, especially when it comes to such groundbreaking news in science, it is really important that there are further studies. And in fact, the head of the research team that discovered dark oxygen is also suggesting that further studies should be carried out to really make sure that dark oxygen exists. In any case, it remains really exciting. So if you like this video, please click on subscribe. And also here you find another video about a new interesting technology. So click on that too. And I say goodbye, or as we say in Germany, auf Wiedersehen.